Hey guys, this is Kyler, and welcome to a new tutorial. Today we're going to be checking out a couple tips and tricks that I use within Audition to transform my slow motion clips. I hope you guys weren't too confused by that intro, but I tried to point out a few key points on the audio that I paid attention to. And I'm going to show you how I manipulate the audio and do all of my effects to create these kind of slow motion designs, as like far as a ramp up, a speed down, a lower pitch, that type of stuff. So for the rest of this video, we're going to be jumping on into Audition. At first, it kind of looks like we just added a couple voice layers into our track, and these are basically just our extra sound effects and our bass layers. All those were created with my voice. First things first, I'm going to delete everything and we're going to start from scratch. So this is the song that we're going to be using, and all you have to do is drag it into Audition under the multi-track area. So now what we're going to do, we're going to pick a spot that we want to start from by zooming in. So I'm just going to hit R on the keyboard and that'll bring up the razor tool, make a cut there, hit V to bring up the selection tool and delete the entire first half and drag this to the beginning. So this is what the beginning sounds like. So you can see it's a little build up into the drop, which is right here. You can kind of see that this drop is really flickery and glitchy, and I really love it. But I'm going to show you a couple techniques that I use. So for the first thing, I'm going to show you the wind up, or when you are trying to wind something in like I did in the very beginning. In order to do this, you kind of have to pick an area on your clip. So let's play through and see what we want. So I think I'm just going to wind it up to this point right here. So in order to do a selection, you can hit I on your keyboard to set an endpoint and O to set an out point. So if you're anywhere on your clip and you want to select everything before it, all you do is hit O and that will select everything before that. You'll double click on our clip and that'll bring us up to the waveform editor. Now this is very important because anything you do in here will be transferred over. It kind of gets a little confusing though. That's why I like selecting everything in my multi-track so I know what I'm getting. All we're going to do is go up to the effects tab and go down to time and pitch and then go to pitch bender process. As soon as we select that, you'll see this dialog box pop up, and this is the pitch bender dialog box. And this is where we'll get all of our manipulation. There's a couple presets. You can do the default one. You can go down a whole step. You can do just winding up. They all do different things. So just play through these. Default will allow you to kind of create your own custom effects if you want, and you can create a spline curve with it as well by checking this button down here. First things first, we're going to actually just select just winding up. As you can see from the start of our clip, just winding up sounds like this. I like that, but I'm going to actually use these keyframes and drag them around to get my perfect wind up that I like. So I'm going to drag this over to the right. The only other thing that you have to do is the quality. I typically always put my quality on perfect or the highest quality possible so that I know it is going to sound amazing. You can also change your range if you want it to be lower, but I found that keeping that at the default works best. And then all you have to do is click apply. And then you'll see that it has been applied to our clip. Now let's go back into our multi-track editor and you can see that our clip has been modified. So let's hit G to remove our time selection and now let's listen to it. So as you can see, we just made a wind up and we're gonna do the exact opposite of that over here and create a wind down on this drop. So we're gonna wind it down on this entire area right before this actual drop. So what we're gonna do is find where we wanna start. Yeah, so right here on the final hit, I'm gonna hit I to set an endpoint. And then I'm going to set the out point right before that big drop. And you can zoom in by your plus and minus signs if you want to get a closer look. So from here, we're going to double click again. And then all I'm going to do is go to the effects tab, go down to time and pitch, go to pitch bender process, and we're going to change the preset to turntable losing power. I'm going to drag my curvature around. Basically, this curve means that wherever this line gets lower and lower, it gets slower and slower, if that makes sense. So you can start to listen to it. So I like how that sounds so glitchy, and since it's being slowed, it just sounds awesome. I'm gonna go to perfect down here and then click apply. And then once I click apply, I'm gonna go back to the multi-track up here, hit G on my keyboard to deselect everything and give that entire section a listen. As you can see, it kind of increased the length a little bit, so that's something to keep in mind. So now it should start slowing down. One thing to keep in note that it doesn't apply or move anything else, only to your selected area. So we have that manipulated right there. So I'm going to hit R on my keyboard to make a cut tool and then V to make the selection tool. And then I'm just going to drag the right half of this drop to the right. All right, so this is where the fun happens. Right now, we're going to create our own vocal effects, and we're going to make a bass drop and breathing noises. Select the entire beginning of this, hit I. And then that will select the rest of our clip. So what we're going to do is double click on our ending audio and then go to the effects rack down to time and pitch and go to pitch bender process. So we're going to change it to default. And then now we can manipulate how we want it to sound. So if I drag this down to 14 semitones right before the drop, what does that sound like? Obviously, it's going to sound terrible. So let's bring this up to around 4 semitones. So I like that. It slows it down a little bit. You can keep playing with whatever you want, but change the quality to perfect and then click apply. Once that applies it onto your clip, you can manipulate the audio however you want and keep playing from there. If you don't like adding the breaths or anything, then you could just simply drag that audio and connect it right there. And then you can also overlay your bass windups and everything will sound like this. We have that wind up going on. The normal audio. The wind down. The bass drop. Everything's winding down. And then it picks back up in the end. The moral of the story is you can manipulate the crap out of your audio within Audition, and I'm really excited to see what you make, but the only thing I really, really wanted to show you is that you can slow down or speed up your audio using like a little turntable effect, but if you guys are curious about more audio manipulation and effects, I can definitely make some more videos on that because honestly, you can go so far with this, and there are so many other effects that I want to show you. I even want to show you guys some stuff about how you can use your own voice to create your transition sound effects. Honestly, I think that's going to be my next video. As always, hit that like button. If you're new here, consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time. Peace.